As I said in this video, we can fold a single piece of paper in half more than 8 times. The current record is 12 folds. But why stop there? Hypothetically speaking, if the average paper thickness is 10th of a millimeter, how many half folds we have to make so that final piece of paper is 1 kilometer tall? 23 folds. How many folds to reach the space 100 kilometers above us? 30 folds. How many until we reach the moon? 42. The sun? 51. And now the final one. How many folds you'd have to make so that final piece of paper is 93 billion light years, or the diameter of the observable universe? Wait for it. 103 folds. Yeah, I was surprised too, but we are not talking about linear growth here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We are talking about exponential growth. Another example is even better. As the story goes, 1,000 years ago, a mathematician named Sessa invented the game of chess. After showing the game to the king, he was so pleased that he gave the inventor the right to name his prize. Sessa, being very cunning, asked the king this, that for the first square of the chessboard, he would receive 1 grain of wheat, 2 for the second one, 4 for the third one, and so forth, doubling the amount each time. Surprised by Sessa's modesty, king said yes. Soon after, he realized his mistake. For the first 10 squares, he received 1,000 grains. For the second 10, 1,000,000. And on the 32nd square, he received 2 billion grains of wheat. And for the last one, he received 9 quintillion. Total number of grains he received? 18 quintillion grains of wheat. That number is so huge that I can't even imagine it. If each grain of wheat weighs 30 milligrams, then all of them would weigh 500 billion tons. If average size of each grain is 4 millimeters, then putting them side by side would take us to the Alpha Centauri and back. That's more than 8 light years. Exponential growth is everywhere around us, yet it's so hard for us to understand it, because it's so unnatural. But anyway, thanks for watching. And please subscribe.